I'm Tenzing Wang Bhutia, and like every Diliwala, I love food. But I'm scared of everything. Even weird food.
But that's exactly what I want to change. And that's why I convinced these guys and Zomato to send me across the country to try some of the most unusual and adventurous food India has to offer.
And today, I'm in Guwahati for some jute pork, pigeon and creepy crawlies.
Oh man.
Chinky, momo, hakka noodle. Are you from China? You must be Korean, right?
Some version of this bullshit is what I get to hear almost every day when I walk the streets of Delhi.
While I get not everyone means to be offensive, I think there's a lack of awareness about India in general and the northeastern states in particular.
I mean, even I don't know much. Thank you, CBSC.
That's why I'm starting my journey into this region at its gateway. Guwahati is a booming city surrounded by hills, beautiful plains, and a rich history that most of the country knows very little about.
For example, in history class, we're taught so much about the Mughals, about Shah Jahan, Babur, Akbar, but not once are we taught about the Ahoms of Assam who defeated them over a dozen times.
What they also did was bring silk into the region. And where there's silk, there are worms. And that's where I come in.
ये सब क्यों हिल रहे हैं?
This is the Belatola market, where twice a week sellers from all over the region bring a variety of unique fruits, vegetables, and animals. Some very unique.
I'll try not to open it from like that side of the I'm scared. No, it's moving. My whole body is itching for some reason. This is so f***ing weird. It kind of looks like the cockroach jo ulta ho jata hai aur fir aise just keeps wiggling, who can't move. मैं थोड़ी पैदा हुई थी ये सब खेलते हुए मेरे को थोड़ी आता ही छूना आई थिंक आई नो व्हाई दे ईट दिस बिकॉज अपेरेंटली इन द जंगल देयर इज नो लाइक चिकन पोल्ट्री फार्मिंग गोइंग ऑन हाउ इट्स कन्वीनियंट इट इज फॉर अस टू गेट चिकन इट्स मूविंग पसीने छूट गए यार इनको देख के
While the Ahoms brought in silk, the Bodos, a tribe that lives on the northern plains of the Brahmaputra, added the worms to their diet. And living by the river, snails also became a Bodo delicacy. And I'm heading to Ordab, a small restaurant that serves these authentic Bodo specialities.
I think snails are just gonna taste like boogers. You know when you have like cold and there's like snot stuck here? I think that's the consistency of the snail it's going to be like. I've actually had insects before in Thailand, but I did not have silkworms because it was too disgusting back then. The inside like pus came out, like how you squeeze a really big pimple. I feel like I'm on fear factor. When I eat this and then fear is not a factor for me. It's like goat turd. What is this bop-sized silkworms that you're feeding me? Ew! Okay, I'm gonna start with the snails. The gravy is so spicy and it's so delicious. बहुत मिर्ची है देयर आर लिटिल बिट ऑफ सैंड आल्सो लाइक पार्टिकल्स ऑफ सैंड दैट आई कैन लाइक ए दिस डजंट टेस्ट बैड एट ऑल This is what the inside looks like, and I thought it would be a lot slimier than this. This is really yummy. I'm okay. It's like I'm playing a mini shunk, but there's no noise that's coming. Okay, I'm gonna have the least intimidating looking one. I can't decide which one, but I think it's... It's not crunchy, it's chewy. Kinda tastes like peanut. The inside tastes a little bit like almonds. It's very pasty, a little bitter, and has a lot of flavor of the onions and the chili and sarso. But my major concern is, what is this white part? Or iske beech mein kya ye black dot types hai? Is that a tatti? If I had to eat this on like the very first episode, I would die. But I feel like I've had so much weird stuff over the span of these few days that I feel like I can conquer the world. Oh my God. Sorry. That was like a really weird part. Every now and then, whenever I get a chance, I call my mom and I tell her how my day is going. And it basically goes like, Mama, they're making me eat shit. I don't wanna do that. This show has been really tough on me. It's pushed me to be out of my comfort zone. These are not things I do on a regular basis. I've cried, I've thrown up. I had a full-blown panic attack. There were times when I did think of giving up meat. Nah, that's never happening. But there's one big advantage. It's time for revenge!
Shh! Don't come at me!
I'm coming for your family, Pigeon.
Well, your distant relatives at least. Pigeon happens to be a local delicacy in Assam, and I'm going to Heritage Korika to try it.
Dude, do you see the claws? They haven't cut the claws. Ye meko ye wala khana hai. Huh? You said there was going to be curry in it. No, don't remove it. It's the barrier between me and the pigeon. This is the exact same plate that my grandmom has in her home. And she goes like, no, but this has minerals. It's good for your body. I don't know. My body seems fine. Ah! Something's biting me. Pigeons, in the culinary term, is called squab. A lot of places have it. I think the Scandinavian countries have it. And French people have it. I know that for a fact. Why the f*** would anybody eat pigeon? Because they're so disgusting. They're so gross. They're so smelly. And they're like the rats of the skies. And I can't believe I'm having this. Probably the meatiest piece in this whole dish. The texture and the taste is very much like mutton. This is like mutton complexion. Initially, when you take a bite into it, it's nice, okay? Because you taste the masala and then you taste the meat, which is fine. Then you chew on it, and when it like starts to dissolve in your mouth, that's when you get like this really weird sort of unfamiliar taste that I'm not used to, and I've had a lot of meat. I don't know what this tastes like though. But the masala is A1, okay? Like the flavor of the curry is really nice.
So because of the flooding in Assam, the people really had to adapt to that. The whole waterlogging scene, the climate is ideal for jute cultivation, and that's why you see them growing a lot of jute. It's supposed to be really rich in nutrients and a lot of minerals. It's a superfood.
supposed to ward off evils and keep you healthy. So it's like all packed in one. Wasting it. Sorry. This is what I was looking forward to the most out of all the things that I was supposed to have in Guwahati. We have pork cooked in jute, which is so funny to say because I've only ever worn jute and carried like two jute tote bags, but I did not know that you could have this. This kind of looks and smells like gundro. Oh my god. It's a little bitter and spicy, but it tastes exactly like gundruk. I don't know how else to explain it to you. I think this might be the same thing that I've had before. And if you're Nepalese, then you will know what I'm talking about. It's not as wild as I had thought it would be. The jute, like the bitterness of the jute, has really gone into the pork. Kya mazedar mixture ho rakha hai. I think the ones that the crew had before was really bitter and they couldn't even have two chamach full of it, and I finished the whole katori, so suck on that.
Shit, I spoke too soon.
Apparently it wasn't hardcore enough and I really enjoyed it, and the crew just can't see me happy. Like Tenzing aur wo khana enjoy karle, it's just not possible. So they got me another version of this, which is apparently supposed to be more hardcore and authentic and way better than what I had. But I have a feeling I might still like this, and then they can suck on that. Immediately, just by the look of it, it looks way too different than the one that I had in the like earlier today. This definitely looks like it has way more jute leaves because they're minced and like kind of in a paste form. It's like ये इतना कड़वा है अंदर जाके पूरी बॉडी ऐसी हो रही है. Let me be honest, it tastes bitter as f. Every bite they have basically pureed the shit out of a dozen of those jute leaves. I hate it. I hate the fact that I have to accept it that I don't like this, because for once I wanted to have something hardcore and still like it. Hell.
By the end of the day, I was feeling pretty badass. I had snails and worms like candy, ate a pigeon, though I think they're the grossest after rats, and I love the jute pork.
Oh my god.
Not that one, that one. I'm starting to feel invincible.
It's not weird enough for me.
If you liked watching this episode as much as we liked making the whole show, then make sure to catch all the episodes exclusively on the Zomato app.